Cryptojacking is well designed for the cloud. According to a 2021 Google Cloud Threat Horizon report, 86% of compromised Google Cloud instances were used for cryptocurrency mining. It's not uncommon for cryptojackers to run up a cloud bill of $100,000 to $500,000 in a single month. Since xmrig, the crypto mining binary, is now dockerized, we need a true CDR solution that will detect crypto mining images used within Kubernetes deployments. As you can see within this Kubernetes deployment, if the Kubernetes attacker actually got access to this environment, they would aim to create workloads with elevated permissions. Within the containers section, you can see the security context is set to privileged to true. We want to avoid this where possible, but in this case, the deployment will be created with that elevated permissions. Similarly, from a cryptojacking perspective, the image for the deployment is using Metal 3D xmrig latest. Once the workload is applied, using kubectl apply, we can see that the deployment was created. And from here, you can see this is an informational alert. It's just telling us which workloads were created within the environment. Looking deeper into it, we can see a warning that there was a workload created with elevated permissions, a privileged pod. Looking up further, the next step they would want to take is giving themselves, again, more permissions within files within the environment. So they would set the user ID or set the group user ID and certain files to give themselves root access. So we can see that here for xmrig.tar, within the temp directory, there was chmod was executed and that the group name is set to root. Once the permissions are given, we'll notice that events or arguments are run where in the temp directory, the xmrig file name is written. Again, this is an indicator of compromise. Similar to what we've seen in the event arguments, anything written in general to the temp directory, we must treat these as sensitive or kind of unusual changes to file directories. Similar to the file name that was written, we want to be able to detect cases where the binary itself is detected. In this case, xmrig-6.18 is the binary that we have on list, and we detect this as malicious behavior. So again, another indicator of compromise tied to this. Going up further, we want to be able to detect on connections going out to mining pools. In this case, we can see that the miner tried communicating with these two IP addresses, as well as the port 3333. Now in this case, it's using both the port and the IP address. To see how this rule was built, we can go into policies, and from here we can click on Access Crypto Mining Network. Now, policies, they use a concept of rules within Falco. So if we go to policies and then rules, we can actually look up how the rule was built. Clicking into the detect outbound connections to common miner pools rule, we can see that it uses a concept of macros to define what are these, again, conditions that we're meeting. So I click on the macro net miner pool, and within here I click on miner pool other, and from here I can see the macros miner's IP and miner's ports. If you want to prevent connections going out to these unusual bad IP addresses that we know are associated with crypto mining, we can click on policies, go into the Access Crypto Mining Network policy, and from here we can edit. Within the policy, we have the options to either, in my case, do nothing and just simply alert and notify the administrator that these IP address or ports have been communicated with, or we have the option to kill using say kill or stop the container itself. Additionally, for additional forensics analysis, we can create a packet capture via the alert actions. Going back to the insights view, there are other ways that we can prevent this crypto mining scenario from playing out. One of them is via drift detection. As you can see, whether xmrig was written in the default directory of the container, or if it was written into temp or any other directory for that matter, we would use a dynamic concept towards deny list to prevent any drift from the original deployment design. Looking into the alerts, there is similar to the connections going out to outbound addresses, we have the option to either prevent drift or alert on drift. Historically, I had enabled drift prevention, but in this case, I'm just alerting now on when drift occurs. So going back to the policy view, we can see that there are these new policy types, container drift and machine learning within Sysdig Secure. In the container drift option, you have the option to prevent, again, to stop any changes to the container. But if you have a legitimate business reason for changes in runtime to a workload, then you may choose to disable and alert what changes those are. As a final line of protection, we go back to the insights view. We can see that there is a crypto mining detection. How this worked, unlike the other fixed condition rules, is we have machine learning. So machine learning will tell us to a confidence rating of 99 to 100% that this was in fact xmrig 6.18, and it was running in this file directory. It was using created as a deployment with a pod name in a certain namespace. And again, it was 100% confident that this was crypto mining activity. From a network perspective, if we wanted to prevent connections from going out to these other addresses, we also have the option to generate Kubernetes network policy within the Sysdig Secure UI. In this case, by isolating the communications that go out between pods within a Kubernetes environment, we have that granular control that we wouldn't have with traditional EDRs that rely on firewall rules that are based solely on IP addresses. Hopefully, showing all of these conditions together, you have a better understanding of why Sysdig Secure's cloud detection and response platform addresses cryptojacking in cloud-native environments. To block cryptojacking and more, try out Sysdig Secure for free today.